So there's a lot of really amazing potential insights there to be gleaned from all of the activity in the skin data that surrounds, and the data that surrounds those skin findings, right? To be able to not only help teams move faster with the code that they write, the issues that they fix, and the releases that they want to get out into production. But I think it really, there's a real big opportunity and potential here for some of these tools to be able to deliver insights to teams to help them internally optimize their AppSec program and be able to get a little bit more proactive with what they're doing from a security perspective. So I would really love to see that come to fruition. I'm hoping that that will be the case sometime relatively soon, but we shall see.
You say sometime relatively soon. It all sounds very exciting and a bit like the Dickens words, great expectations. When can we expect to see these changes? You know, what is available now or on the near horizon?
Sure. So I know that a lot of vendors at the moment, in terms of AI specifically, when we're talking about AI and SAST and how they blend together, there are a lot of vendors taking the approach right now of how can we use AI to give developers a remediation path or advice to be able to understand what to do about the findings that they are able to surface. So that's already in existence. And I think a lot of vendors are working on refining how they provide that guidance and the depth of that guidance and pulling in some context around there to make things more specific and valuable for each individual developer when they get those findings back. So that's already in existence. Being able to use AI to transform how we determine what is a risk is in place right now, but I haven't seen any vendors, and Amir, you can totally correct me if I'm wrong, if you've seen this and feel differently, but I haven't seen any vendors do this effectively just yet. I know that there are a handful of companies that are working to do this, so I would expect that that would be ready and available for folks probably within the next, I honestly hesitate to say within the next year, because it very well could be faster. You know, a lot of teams move very quickly, but I would be very surprised if within the next year we don't see a couple of vendors being able to come forth with a bit of a better analysis of some of the findings that they're able to surface.
Amir, what's your view?
I think Sony will be surprised at how many vendors are actually working on this as well as we speak, right? It's something that is actively going along in the background, right? People are working on implementing AI, whether it's in SAST, whether it's in the whole AST suite as a whole. It's being used very, very dramatically, right? And that's for the reasons that we've explained. It's a far more efficient process. AI can learn much quicker than we can, and it can give better results to be able to actually move forward, right? So I feel, I definitely agree with Saoirse, where in the next year or even sooner, we can really see some dramatic changes, not just for SAST, but for the whole application security sort of testing as a whole, whether it's at the ASPM side of things, connecting the dot, correlating things, or whether it's actually giving you detection and giving you remediation. I feel like we're going to see a real sort of disruption in the market with AI. And it's for the better, right? We've been working in a way that we have for all of these years. It's been great. But when there are better tools to be able to make things more efficient, make things faster, it's just the logical way to move forward. So I really do feel like it's going to be a dramatic change, but it's going to be a change for the better, and it's going to be sooner than we expect.
Okay. Now we've just got enough time to take a couple of questions. So first one coming in, we hear that a lot of vendors are moving to a platform approach. What's your view, and what are the benefits of your approach?
Yeah, happy to say this one.
I can jump in too.
Go for it, yeah.
So yes, a lot of vendors are moving to more of a platform approach. You'll see some of the more typical application security testing vendors now trying to make the information that they're able to provide more valuable. And I think we talked a lot about context. I think a platform approach gives some of these vendors the freedom and flexibility to be able to connect the dots across different products, different findings, different tool sets, even too, with integrations. It makes things a lot more valuable to the end user. So I think the major drive here, at least from a value perspective or from a vision and goal perspective, especially on the men's side, right, is to be able to give developers, engineers, AppSec leaders, folks that are actively trying to reduce the organization's level of risk and who are responsible for actively executing on those tasks, right, a better, clearer path forward of what do I need to do? What is a risk for me? Why is it a risk for me? Can I understand how all of those pieces fit together? And then what do I need to go do to be able to address those things? And another benefit of that, that sometimes we kind of forget about, right, is what I had touched on a little bit earlier in terms of being able to take a step above and look at some of the trends going on across your organization, whether that's with a certain type of finding, whether that's within a certain pattern of behavior that continues to introduce risk into your software development lifecycle. There's a lot of data there that if you're able to break down some of those silos and let those findings be able to be brought together, it gives you a very, very valuable view of what's going on in terms of risk across your application attack surface. So you'll see things like reporting becoming a lot more valuable and richer with data. You'll see a lot of vendors are putting together dashboards so that folks who are responsible for managing their AppSec tools can easily understand at a point in time, what is going on? What do I need to look at? What are areas of concern? There's a lot of benefits to be had there in terms of interoperability and how you process that data and the value that you're able to deliver to your customers to be able to make them actually be able to take their AppSec program and make it impactful and become a little bit more proactive with what they're doing rather than trying their best to tread water when there's waves and waves and waves that continue to come.
Do you want to add to that, Amir?
I think Saoirse covered all the points there. There's nothing more to add to. It's a fantastic answer there.
Excellent. Next question. When it comes to the quality versus security debate, if we look after code quality, why is that not enough?